Hi everyone, Aaron here for zollotech, and iOS 15 has a bunch of changes, in fact probably more than the previous two versions combined. However, many of those are not visual changes, but rather refinements to the OS. So I wanted to go over 10 or more features that you may not know about iOS 15. And the first thing has to do with Siri. Siri now has the ability to share photos, web pages, news articles, and other things directly from the phone. So if we go to Safari, for example, and then I'll press and hold the power sleep wake button, but you could use the keyword hey and then the name after that, but let's go ahead and do that. Share this with Zach.
Ready to send it?
It understands the context. We'll stop there, but it understands the context, will let you send the web page, and if you're in private browsing, it will take a screenshot and send that web page as well. So it now understands that where you couldn't do this with iOS 14. So that's built into this. Also, another thing you can do that has to do with sending things is on the Apple Watch, if you have watchOS 8, the betas or the final version, and you go to messages, if you go to send a message on your phone, you'll get a little dropdown or notification that you can use the keyboard on your iPhone to fill in the text message on your Apple Watch. So I can type the word, hey, and you'll see immediately on the Apple Watch, it shows up. It shows up. And you can see it's showing up in real time as I type. So now they connect together, similar to what you have with an Apple TV, for example, when you're using the remote, you go to search for something, it pops up and asks you on your iPhone if you want to use the keyboard, just to make it a little bit easier. So you now have that option if you want to easily switch back and forth between both of them. Now with iOS 15, you probably have already heard of Private Relay with iCloud Plus. However, there's some more customization that can be done with this. Now you need iCloud Plus and of course iOS 15. But if you go into your settings and go to your name, tap on iCloud, under iCloud, you'll have Private Relay. This hides your information online, sort of like a VPN, but it's a little bit different than that. And I can talk about that more in detail in a different video if you'd like. But if you have Private Relay turned on, you now have the option to customize this on a per Wi-Fi connection basis. So if we go back to our main settings page, then we'll go to Wi-Fi. Under Wi-Fi, tap the I next to your Wi-Fi connection, and you'll see if you scroll down, it says iCloud Private Relay. You can turn this off if you're on a maybe a home network you know is secure, has its own firewall, for example. But if maybe you're at a hotel or something like that and connected to public Wi-Fi, you can turn it on there. So it doesn't have to be on all the time, as sometimes it does seem to slow down the connection. Maybe this will improve in the future, but you can turn it on and off on a per Wi-Fi connection basis. So depending on what you're connected to, you now have that option. Now with photos, there's some changes as well. So if we go into photos and just tap on a photo, this is from a similar video, but about iPad OS from the other day, we'll tap on edit. And under edit, some of the symbols have changed for editing. If I go to the same thing on a previous iOS version, I'll bring that in here with iOS 14.7, for example, tap on edit, you'll see that the symbols have been updated a little bit. If we go into the filters here, you can see there's the new filters, and then editing in general looks basically the same, but they've updated those symbols. However, we have much more editing options or capability built into photos on iOS 15. And what I mean by that is if we go back, we'll click cancel here, or tap cancel, go back. And if we select multiple photos, we can select a bunch of them. And if we go to share, once we've shared and we scroll down, we can now edit the date and time all at once in bulk editing. So we can edit the location or date and time all at once for all of those photos. So we no longer have to do this individually or one by one on our iPhone. We now have multiple editing capability across all photos now. So bulk editing of date and time. Now also, just like iPad OS, we can now drag and drop throughout the OS. Now you may or may not have been aware of this, but this is something that was in iPad OS before. But if maybe we select this one, press and hold, and we'll just drag it off here, tap a couple different ones. Now we're dragging these, swipe up, and now maybe go into notes. If we go into notes, we can drag those into notes and give it just a moment and it will import them into notes. So now we have those photos within notes. So that's something that's new with iOS 15. Drag and drop is really helpful and I'm glad to see it brought over to iOS as well. Now, if we go into the camera, there's some updates as well. So let's go over to this iPhone. So we'll go into Notes. Now with the iPhone 11 on the left and the 12 Pro Max on the right, you can see that the notes have already synced and everything I've dragged and dropped shows up the same. But at the top, there's an email address, tim@apple.com. If I take my iPhone 12 Pro Max, go to the camera, we can use a feature called Live Text. Now you may be already familiar that you can copy and paste text directly from a different photo, for example. So if you hit this little button here, it will recognize the text, but it also recognizes context. So if I tap on that photo, it says, I realize that's an email. Let me set that up as an email address and have you send from that. So now we can send an email directly to that email address. So it not only understands that it is text, but also understands the context of the message. If we go back to the camera, we'll tap on the live text icon to make it go away. And if we scroll down on the same note, you'll see there's a URL or a website address. Again, we can do the same thing. Wait for it here. It recognizes, and it is a little bit slow. It may speed up in the future, but you'll see it's a little bit slow at this time. There we go. It recognizes it, apple.com, and we'll go over to apple.com and it brings us to Safari. So it's super helpful. Maybe there's a website address or URL on a poster. You want to check that out. It's much easier to do that with iOS 15. Now you can use the same thing directly from Safari as well. If we tap on the website address bar here, we can now text from camera. It does the same thing. It just brings you back and now opens up the camera at the bottom to look for the same thing. So again, it's looking for something here and it's recognizing the addresses immediately. And you can just tap on insert. So it does the same thing the exact same way, but you can do that either with the camera directly or from Safari directly. Now within Safari, there's a nice little easy tip or trick. You swipe to the right when you're at the bottom and it immediately opens up a new tab. So that's something that's different as well. And then also if you open up a link that was shared with you, as you can see here, it says from Andy, and we tap on this link at the top, it tells you who shared that to you. So it's a nice little link back to whoever shared that with you. And it's a nice way to see who that was from. So that tells you it's from this person, Andy. I can tap on that, go right back into messages and see who it was from. The same is true across different things such as photos, for example. So if you go into photos and you tap the eye, it will tell you who sent it to you. So let's try that. So if we go back into photos, tap on the photo down here at the bottom. This is a new Lego. It says from Zach and it's the Koenigsegg Jesko Lego. So he was just sharing that with me, what it looks like. And if you tap the eye here, it will tell you the same thing, what it was shot as, more metadata, and who shared it with you. So all of that information is now included directly in photos, in news, in Safari as well. So it's really nice, as well as music, to see who shared things with you. And it just gives you more and more context. Now, if we go into Maps, in Maps, of course, you've probably seen the new globe. If you have an A12 Bionic or newer, you'll have this globe. And if we search Maps, maybe for a larger city, one nearby, it gives us more information about that city. So it's giving us population information, elevation, area, and also its overall distance. This works on many large cities, so New York City, for example. So we'll just find New York, New York. And again, it's showing population information, elevation, area, and distance. So it's showing all of that information and it's just updated with a little bit more helpful information. Now this doesn't necessarily work on smaller areas, but it is in larger cities as well. Now, one final thing I wanted to share with you has to do with the iPad. People have asked me to show this, and it's something I didn't mention in an iPadOS video as well. Now, on iPadOS, there's a feature I didn't mention in a previous video that I thought I'd share here that some others have asked me to talk about, and that's the ability to add an image to the drawing area of notes when you're on an iPad. So if you go into Notes, for example, and then maybe you just have some text here you've typed, and then you have a written note at the bottom. Well, with the written note, you can now bring an image into that note. So if we go back over to the previous one I showed you, press and hold, we'll drag here, tap back on the other one, and let's just drag it right here and drop it. If we tap on this, we now have the option to move this around. We can resize it if we want. Maybe we'll make it a little bit smaller or a little bit bigger right here. Tap on it again, and now we have the option to draw on it. So we can draw whatever we'd like. So we could circle this if we want, change the text color, for example. Maybe we want this. We want to circle it in red, bring an arrow here, It's a terrible arrow, but we'll bring an arrow here. And then you could mark this up all you want. You can then move it again if you'd like, or bring in another image. So you can use this along with anything you draw that you'd like, and then resize your image and move it around. So you now have the option to do that in Notes. Now, finally, you may have not heard this, but Apple has now updated iOS 15 and iPadOS 15 to support NTFS file systems. That's NT file system from Windows. So maybe you have a Windows computer, you need to move different files between your Windows computer, maybe at a school, to your iPhone or your iPad, you can now use the Files app to move those files seamlessly. Before, it was a bit of a pain. So they've added that support. It should be super helpful for a lot of people. And so there's quite a few new features. There's a lot more that I'm sure we'll find throughout time, but let me know if there's any that you think are significant that I haven't mentioned in this video or the previous videos as well. If you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, of course, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.